Hello, today's video is on stock number 35525TE, or the manufacturer Zotek's ZT203 handheld pen digital multimeter. Let's go ahead and comes with the little manual, comes with a little pouch. The meter itself, probe, and an alligator clip. First thing I'm going to do is it comes with these nice little safety covers, so you can reach into little corners easily, not shorting anything out. It comes with the alligator clip. Let me just go ahead and pull it out of the rubber boot so you'll see it. So you can hook that up to your negative probe. Hook it up and clip it off somewhere for you if you need to. Plugs into the back end of it. I have already installed batteries, so you don't have to see me do that. It's just a little Phillips screw. Okay. I'm going to just quickly go through the different features just so you can see it working. To start with, you have the red button. That is the on-off. Press and hold. Turns the unit on. And first thing I'm going to do is just so you see better is the second button. It says hold and light. You press and hold and turns on the backlighting for the meter. The next section is the yellow button at the top. Now it is either in or out. You have two little symbols. You see it there in the video. And now that's two different sets of ranges. The top one is with the out, and it starts with DC volts. Just quickly to show you, just a 9 volt battery. It is auto ranging. I really won't step there, but if you click on the range button, you can change to manual and stay in a certain range. But most people like auto ranging. Next one, next one is AC volts. And I happen to have a nice little extension cord plugged in here just to show you what it looks like. Plug it in. Make contact. Yeah, 112. And you press the red button again and you get to the next range of hertz. This is AC hertz, so press it and you'll see it's, make contact, 59.9. And you press the red button again and you get the near field AC sniffer. The sensor is along this bottom edge right here, so when you get next to it, helps detect, let you know when there is AC present. It doesn't really work well anywhere else on the meter, just right there. Okay, that is with all the functions with the button out. You press the button again. Let's turn back on our backlight. Why'd you turn off? Okay, this is DC millivolts, first range. Hit the red button again, and you get to AC millivolts. Really don't have a load to show you. Now you press red again, and you're into resistance. Now let's see, this is the, just to show you real quickly, ...22 ohm resistor. Oh, didn't mean to do that. Press the hold button. Okay, and here's just to show you a 1 meg resistor. Okay, that's the it. Then we press the red button again, and we get into audible continuity. Next range is your diode tester. I have a little diode over here. Yeah, 5.3. Okay, yeah. Standard diode tester. Next range is capacitance. Just happen to have a little, what do we have here? 1,000 microfarad. Okay, minus. And hook up the capacitor. And just, that brings us back to frequency, low voltage frequency. And we have this one set at about, is that 96 hertz? Oh, 96 kilohertz. Ah, that's the 0.8. And we can run it up to 160 kilohertz. Pretty close. Okay, and see, what else do we have? Ah, that should bring us back to the beginning. That's back to the beginning. What's nice is you have this other button here, relative and light. You press and hold, and it turns on a nice little flashlight so you can see where you're working. Press and hold again, turns it off. Now to the relative button. Now that's interesting little feature. Let me get into AC here. The way that would work is my little plug here. Now this happened to be hooked up to a variac just to show you for. Okay. Okay, we have when you make connection 111 volts. Now if you press the relative button, it zeroes it out. You have this little triangle come up, so be sure you see that feature. So that way, when you go to test somewhere further down the line and you want to see what the difference was from your original source, like I said, I'm turning down a variac off screen here. You can see you now have a 17 volt difference between your original set point to your separate set point. Interesting feature, if you have a use for it. Other than that, you obviously have the hold button. I didn't get you actually hold, displays hold. Other than that, it has a 15 minute auto shut off. At 14 minutes, it gives you a beep warning. Other than that, I think we covered all the talking points on it. All right. Thank you for watching our video.